In this example, we are given with a circuit, and in the circuit shown in figure, we are required to find the potential difference across points VA and VD. We are required to find VA minus VD. Here, if we solve the problem by using Kirchhoff's voltage law, we can see there are two loops. And say we consider currents in the loops as I1 and I2 in the situation. And we can easily write the KVL equation for I1, that is for this loop. And for this, if we start from this point, then on moving along with the current, you can see we are getting a gain of 10 volt. Then it is minus 2I1. Then it is minus 3I1. And at the end of the loop, it should be equal to 0. And solving this equation, you can see we are getting the value of I1, which is 10 by 5, that is 2 ampere. The same can also be obtained directly, like if we ignore this branch connected at terminal B, because there is no return path for this branch in the same circuit. We can say that no current flowing in this loop will pass through this branch, because in a branch current will pass only when there is a return path to the same circuit. Now, in this loop, there is no return path, so no current will flow through the branch. And we can say this 2 ohm, 3 ohm resistance are connected in series across a 10 volt battery. So, current will be 10 by 5, that is 2 ampere directly we can obtain. Similarly, for the second loop, we can write KVL equation. Here, we write KVL equation for I2. Here, we can start from any point. Say, we start from point D. Then, along with the current, we can write minus 4I2, the potential drop across 4 ohm. Then it is minus 6I2. Then it will be minus 20 is equal to 0. And on simplifying, the value of I2 we are getting is minus of 20 by 10, that is minus 2 ampere. This could also be obtained directly, like here also, as no current will flow through this branch because no return path is there. We can consider 6 ohm and 4 ohm in series across 20 volt battery. So, the current will be 20 by 10, that will be 2 ampere only. And here it is with negative sign we are obtaining. That means actually current is not flowing clockwise, it is an anti-clockwise manner, because this 20 volt battery is supplying the current. And as we are required to find the potential difference across points A and D, now we write KVL equation from point A to D. Here, if we write the KVL equation from point A to D, from A we can start, where we consider the potential to be VA, and along this direction we can say at point B the potential will be a drop of minus 3I1. In this direction there will be a gain due to a 4 volt battery, and no potential drop will occur across this 1 ohm resistance as no current is flowing in this branch. Now we reach point C and to point D. As current is flowing in upward direction as we have drawn here, so it will be a gain of potential, that will be plus 4I2, and finally we are getting the potential D. So in this equation, if we simplify it for VA minus VD, you can see here we are getting 3I1 minus 4I2 minus 4. And if we substitute the values of I1 and I2, it will be 3 multiplied by 2 minus of 4 multiplied by minus 2 minus 4. That will be 6 plus 8 minus 4, and that will be 14 minus 4, so that will be 10 volt. That will be the answer to this problem, the potential difference across terminals A and D, what is asked in the problem.